Welcome to the University of Waterloo's Software Engineering Information Session. Whether you're just starting your research or preparing to apply, we're happy you're here. My name is Abby, and I'm the Undergraduate Recruitment Specialist for the Faculty of Engineering at Waterloo. In this session, I'll give you a quick overview of our software engineering program, including what you'll learn, the types of co-op jobs students pursue, and how it compares to similar programs such as computer engineering and computer science. Before we dive in, I'd like to introduce Dr. Victoria Sacchini, the director of the Software Engineering Program here at Waterloo. Dr. Sacchini is a teaching stream associate professor in the School of Computer Science, and she works closely with both students and faculty to support the academic success and growth of the SE program. You'll likely hear her name again if you join the program. She's a key part of the community and an excellent resource for both current and prospective students. If you have any questions about our software engineering program, I encourage you to reach out to her at se-director@uwaterloo.ca. So, what exactly is software engineering? At its core, it's about applying math, science, and engineering principles to the design and development of software. The focus is on real-world application. Students don't just learn theory, they learn how to build complex, reliable systems using industry tools, design principles, and team-based practices. At Waterloo, the program is co-delivered by the School of Computer Science and the Department of Electrical and Computer Engineering. This gives students the best of both worlds, a strong theoretical foundation, and the hands-on engineering experience. As I mentioned, what really sets Waterloo's software engineering program apart is that it's a true collaboration between two powerhouse faculties, engineering and mathematics. On the engineering side, you'll take courses through our Electrical and Computer Engineering Department, or ECE, Canada's largest ECE department with over 90 professors. This side of the program brings deep technical expertise and the understanding that computers are fundamentally electronic devices. ECE teaches about half of the software engineering curriculum. On the math side, you'll learn from faculty in our School of Computer Science, which is part of our Faculty of Mathematics. With over 80 professors, it's one of the strongest CS departments in the country and a global leader. Here, the focus is on computation as a way of thinking and how software systems are designed and reasoned about. This dual faculty model means that you're not just learning how to code, you're developing the engineering mindset, mathematical rigor, and practical skills to design reliable, scalable software systems. Students often ask, what's the difference between software engineering, and computer science? This slide gives you a high-level look at how they compare. All three programs share a strong foundation in software, artificial intelligence, and co-op, but how you get there and what you focus on looks a little different. Computer engineering, part of the Faculty of Engineering, leans more into hardware and systems. CE students explore areas like automatic vehicles, chip design, and robotics, alongside fundamentals like circuits and electronics. It's also a cohort-based program, meaning students move through their core courses together, which helps foster teamwork and a strong sense of community. Computer science, which is again offered through our Faculty of Mathematics, gives students more individual choice in course selection. There's a stronger focus on data science, theory, and user-facing applications like UI and graphics. CF students have more flexibility to tailor their degree path. Software engineering sits in between. It combines the depth of engineering with the breadth of computer science, but with a specialized focus on building large, scalable software systems. You'll take courses in areas like software architecture, software requirements, and software testing, key components of managing complex real-world software. And like computer engineering, SE is also a cohort-based program. You'll take your core courses with the same group of students throughout your degree. This helps build community, eases collaboration on projects, and gives you a built-in support network from day one. If you'd like to explore this comparison in more detail, we've included a link at the bottom of the slide with a full breakdown. Now let's talk a little bit about fit, because software engineering is a fantastic program, but it's not for everyone. You should consider SE if you're someone who genuinely enjoys things like software, engineering, math, and science. If you're curious about hardware and circuits, you like working on teams, and you get excited by open-ended design challenges, this program will likely feel like a great match. But we also want to be transparent about what doesn't work so well. If you're thinking about SE just because someone told you it's more prestigious, or because it's hard to get into, or because you're not sure what else to choose, those aren't great reasons. In fact, the quotes that you see on the right are all real comments from students who left SE. They realized too late that the program wasn't what they actually wanted, and we'd much rather help you find the right fit from the start. So ask yourself, do I enjoy problem solving? Do I like working in teams? Am I interested in both theoretical and practical sides of computing? If so, SE could be a great path for you. Now let's take a look at what students actually learn in the program, starting in the first year. This is where they build a strong foundation that prepares them for more advanced topics later on. On the computer science side, they learn how data and algorithms work, explore digital logic and circuits, and take discrete math to understand the logic behind software. On the engineering and math side, they dive into programming, calculus, and linear algebra, while also building teamwork and communication skills through problem solving and professional development. Altogether, they get a well-rounded start in both software and hardware, setting them up for success in later terms. Now let's walk through the four major subject areas that students explore throughout the software engineering program. The first, and perhaps most central, is of course programming and software development. This is where students learn to build software from the ground up, starting with basic coding and moving on to full applications. They learn multiple programming languages like Python, Java, and C++, along with industry tools like Git and GitHub. They also explore how software is built in teams, how to organize and design code, and how to test and debug their work. Eventually, they build real apps for the web and mobile, learning both the front end, which is what users see, and the back end, which is how everything works behind the scenes. These skills form the core of what students will use throughout the program and in their co-op jobs. The second major subject area is computer systems and architecture. This area focuses on how computers work behind the scenes and how software interacts with hardware. Students learn how processors, memory, and operating systems function, and how software manages tasks like running programs and handling files. They also explore embedded systems, like the software that runs in smart devices or robots, as well as parallel and distributed computing, which helps computers solve problems faster by working together. Finally, they dive into security and performance optimization, learning how to protect systems and make them run more efficiently. This area gives students a deeper understanding of how everything fits together, essential knowledge for anyone interested in systems, hardware, or performance-focused roles. The third major area is algorithms and data structures. This is all about solving problems efficiently and organizing information in smart ways. Students learn tools like lists, stacks, and trees to manage data and explore algorithms for sorting and searching through it quickly. As they move forward, they tackle more advanced concepts like graphs, hash tables, and strategies such as dynamic programming to solve complex problems. They also learn how to measure how fast or efficient their solutions are, which helps them choose the best approach when working with large amounts of data. These skills are essential for everything from building apps to acing co-op interviews. The final major area is software engineering principles and project management. This is where students learn how to apply their technical skills in real-world team-based projects, building software that's well-planned, reliable, and ready for users. They cover the full software development lifecycle, from idea to final product, and explore industry practices like Agile to manage teamwork and timelines. Students also learn about software design patterns, systems architecture, and how to build code that's scalable and maintainable. Just as importantly, they develop project management, communication, and ethical decision-making skills, preparing them to lead teams and build software that's safe, responsible, and impactful. In the later years of the software engineering program, students get the chance to explore advanced topics and connect everything they've learned. Some dive into areas like optimization, microservices, or cybersecurity, including ethical hacking and system protection. Others explore user experience design, cognitive computing, or scalable cloud systems. There are also opportunities to explore the future of tech through electives, research, and co-op. Students interested in areas like AI, quantum computing, VR or AR, smart infrastructure, or even brain-computer interfaces can choose to go deeper. These topics build on core skills and give students the chance to specialize, innovate, and prepare for careers at the leading edge of technology. Software engineering is a pretty structured program, but students do have some flexibility to customize their degree, especially if they're interested in diving deeper into a particular area. Let's start with specializations. These are built right into the software engineering program, and they allow students to focus their elective courses around a specific theme. There are four specializations in the software engineering program. These are artificial intelligence, business, computational fine arts, and human-computer interaction. If you complete a specialization, it's officially noted on your diploma. It's a nice way to show you've built some expertise in a particular area. In addition to those, students can also choose to add what's called an engineering option. These are offered across the Faculty of Engineering and cover a wide range of topics, things like management sciences, entrepreneurship, quantum engineering, environmental engineering, and more. However, it's important to know that options usually require you to take extra courses beyond the standard degree requirements, so they are better fit for students who are open to a slightly heavier course load and who are ready to plan ahead. One of the biggest strengths of the software engineering program at Waterloo is co-op. This is where students alternate between school and paid work terms. By graduation, most students have completed six co-op work terms, which adds up to 2 years of real work experience. Early on, students might start with hands-on tasks like testing or scripting. As they gain experience, they take on roles like app development, full-stack work, or automation. Either final co-ops, many lead parts of projects, or work directly with clients and teams. Waterloo runs the largest co-op program in North America, and it shows. 96% of our co-op grads land jobs in their field within 6 months of graduation, compared to just 83% of grads across Ontario. Students work across industries, from startups to big tech, finance, and research, both in Canada and internationally. By the time they graduate, they're not just ready to start their careers, they've already started. At Waterloo, co-op programs follow something called a stream. Basically, a schedule that outlines when you're in school and when you're on a work term. In software engineering, everyone starts in Stream 8X, which includes 6 4-month co-op terms starting in the spring of first year. In your third year, you can choose to switch into Stream 8Y if you would like to. Either way, both streams have an 8-month co-op term at the end of your degree, allowing you to gain some experience taking on a longer-term project. After graduation, software engineering students go on to work in a wide range of roles and industries. Many become software engineers or full-stack developers, while others specialize in areas like mobile development, UI and UX design, DevOps, or AI and machine learning. You'll also find grads working as cloud engineers, data engineers, game developers, security specialists, or product managers. They work across industries from tech and finance to healthcare, transportation, e-commerce, and gaming at companies like Google, Shopify, RBC, and many more. Thanks to the combination of coursework and co-op, our grads are work-ready and often enter the job market with real-world experience and clarity about their goals. And for those who want to keep learning, grad school is also an option, with students pursuing master's or PhD programs in engineering, computer science, artificial intelligence, or other related programs. A common question we get is, how do I get into software engineering at Waterloo? First, it's important to know that there's no set cutoff average for admission. The required average changes every year depending on the number of applications we receive and how competitive the applicant pool is. That said, for software engineering, successful applicants usually have averages that are at least in the low to mid-90s. But it's not just about your grades. We also look at other important pieces. First is your AIF. That's your admissions information form. This is where you tell us more about who you are beyond your transcript. What have you done outside of class? What projects have you worked on? Why are you interested in software engineering? This is your chance to show your passion, initiative, and fit for the program. Second is the online video interview. It's not a technical test, but it gives us a better sense of how you communicate and your motivations for studying software engineering at Waterloo. And third is your programming experience. Software engineering applicants are required to have experience writing well-structured modular programs, and that experience must be demonstrated through at least one of the following: either strong performance in a high school programming course, such as grade 11 or grade 12 computer science, significant work or internship experiences that involves programming, or other meaningful programming experience, like personal projects, online courses, hackathons, or open source contributions. At Waterloo Engineering, you'll definitely work hard, but you'll also find tons of ways to have fun, meet new people, and get involved. There's a really vibrant student community here, full of people who love to build things, join clubs, play sports, volunteer, and just hang out. You might sing with an a cappella group, join a design team and compete internationally, play on a varsity or intramural sports team, or become an engineering ambassador, helping future students find their path. One of the biggest parts of student life here is ENGSOC, the Waterloo Engineering Society. It's known as Canada's most active student society. They run events, support clubs, advocate for students, and create a real sense of community. Whether you're into music, robotics, sustainability, student leadership, or just meeting new people, there's a place for you here. We also have a big emphasis on support and inclusion. There are mentorship programs, wellness resources, and student groups focused on everything from cultural identity to gender diversity to academic support. So no matter who you are or where you're coming from, you'll find people here who get you and who will support you through the highs and lows of your engineering journey. That brings us to the end of this session. Thanks so much for watching. If you have more questions, don't worry. There are a few great ways to follow up and get the information you need. If you'd like to hear directly from our current students, check out our Ask a Warrior chat platform. You can connect with real Waterloo Engineering students to ask about academics, co-op, residence, student life, whatever's on your mind. For admissions-related questions like requirements, timelines, or the application process, feel free to reach out to our team at enginfo@uwaterloo.ca. And if you're thinking about visiting campus or joining one of our events, head over to our tours and events page to see what's coming up, whether that's in person or virtual. Thanks again for tuning in, and we hope to see you at Waterloo Engineering.